Okay, I've got a professional, precision, and efficient dust particle counter. And it's come in a box, And the reason I've got it is I read a few articles online about microparticle production or emission from filament 3D printing, and I wanted to be able to check while printing what kind of quantity of particles are produced, and to then make a decision whether to enclose the printers and filter the air when working with them. I mean, this seems okay, and I've already put the battery in. I've used it a few times. It seems to be working, although I haven't been able to identify a test to check whether this is accurate. Essentially what I've done is watched a Matthias Wandel video where he used a particle counter and looked at the readings he was getting and compared them to what I was getting with this thing here within the workshop, and it seems more or less accurate. Managed to change the settings so that I have three different sizes of particles that I'm reading. So you've got 0.3, 2.5 and 10, 3 micrometers. And it's reading as pieces per liter, and as far as I can tell, that's very similar to parts per million. And what I'm going to do is run a few tests with this while using my sander with and without the extraction, with two different types of sandpaper, and also with the air filter on and off, and we'll just see what kind of readings we get on this thing here. First thing to mention is that you also get a reading of the temperature and the relative humidity. So in this room it's 20 degrees at the moment, because it's warming up now, it's summer, and the humidity is about 51%. But I do have a humidifier running pretty much non-stop in here. So let's start by doing a sample count. Essentially all you do is press run. You get a countdown from 50. And about halfway through you do get initial reading, and then at the end you get the sample. Okay, that's a lot higher than last time. Normally it's around 10,000. In the book, a little reference table somewhere, that's heavy pollution. Interesting. I'm going to turn my air filter on and do a couple readings and write those down. Normally when I do any cutting or sanding, I have this on in the background. Go do a reading outside. Okay, I've just come back from outside, and that's outside. That's really high. I actually took this to work with me and used it while changing the bags in the dust extraction room. I didn't see any at 10 microns come up on the reading, but it went up to 90,000 on the lowest one, 0.3, and I thought that was a lot. It seems on this fine day in London, the pollution is quite high, but I'm going to just check the pollution count and pollen count from the Met Office and just compare it to what I'm getting for my area. Maybe it's just a particularly bad day. Okay, I found a website, London Air Pollution Real Time Air Quality Index, AQ1. So I'm in Wandsworth at the moment. So their reading is 112 parts per million. 2.5 micron, and I'm getting 380 pieces per litre. So one part per million is equivalent to 1 million grams of something per litre of water. The readings on this pieces per litre equivalent to parts per million. Yeah, it's quite high. I'm going to do some readings in other parts of the building. Okay, so I've just run around the building doing a few different counts, and it's consistently high everywhere. The website I found with a live pollen count or pollution count or whatever seems to be high as well, so they seem to correlate. I guess it depends on the area, you'd have peaks and troughs. But I thought what I'll try today. I think there's no point doing the sanding experiment because this is affecting the information coming out on this. But I'm going to turn my fan on, take the hose off the extractor for the table sonder there. That's got a HEPA filter. I'm going to let that run for a little bit. I'll also do the same with the pneumatic over there. Give it a couple minutes running and then turn this on and run it again. Okay, it has dropped down a bit. Maybe if I left the two extractors and the air scrubber running for quite a while longer, maybe that would drop down even more, but I think I'm battling against real life now and I ain't going to win in this leaky building. It's dropped from 140 to 110. Okay, so there's no point doing the sanding experiment today. Another way to check how much dust you're producing, albeit in a qualitative way, is the Tyndall dust beam lamp. Look at this shot from my previous video. The camera is acting like an observer while my body is blocking the light source, which is behind me, and the shadow behind the table saw helps illuminate the dust coming off the machine. So if you don't have a dust counter or not willing to spend the money to get one, you can still check how much dust is coming off your machines and think about changing how your extraction works or other preventative measures to reduce your exposure. Compare the previous shot with this one from a different angle and you can barely see any dust coming off the machine. It is still being produced. I'll link to the particle counter that I'm using and some other examples as well as a video from the HSC on how to check for dust using the Tyndall dust lamp. Hope that was interesting, thanks again for watching and you'll see me in the next one.